Hi, this is Anil from Learning Lad and welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, we will see how we can write a simple program where we will be asking the user to enter an alphabetical character, and when the user is going to enter that alphabetical character, we will say whether he has entered the uppercase alphabetical character or the lowercase alphabetical character. Here in this video, I will be using the C programming language. You can do the same thing in the C++ also. And you guys can write this program in many ways. And in this video, we are going to use the switch statement. And in the switch statement's case values, instead of specifying a constant value, we will be specifying a range of values. Now here, let's get started. I have already created the skeleton of this program. I have included this stdio.h header file, which allows us to use the functions like printf, scanf, etc. And then we have returned this main function here, which is the entry point of our program. Now here in this program, first let us declare some of the variables that we are going to use. The first variable that we need is for storing the character entered by the user. And since we are working with the character data type, my variable's type will be of type char. And then I need to give a name. I will say ch. And this is the only variable that we need for this program. Now, next, what we're gonna do is we're gonna ask the user to enter an alphabetical character, and we are going to display a message saying that, and we are going to do that using the printf function. So I will use the printf function, and here I will say, please enter an alphabetical character. And then I'm gonna insert a new line here. And then after seeing this message, user is gonna enter a character. We are going to read that character and we are going to store that in this ch variable. So I will be using the scanf function. And here, since we are reading a value of type character type, the format specifier will be %c. And here I need to specify the address of the ch variable. For this scanf function to work properly, we need to provide the address of the variable where we want to store the information. Here we want to store the information read into this variable ch, and that's why we are using this ampersand symbol with this ch variable, which gets the address of this ch variable. Alright, now we have displayed a message asking the user to enter an alphabetical character, and when the user is going to enter that character, we are reading that character and we are storing that in this ch variable. Now the next thing that we are going to do is we are going to check whether the user has entered the uppercase character or the lowercase character. Now let's talk about the types of input that the user can provide here. Number one, the user will enter an uppercase alphabetical character. Number two, the user is going to enter a lowercase alphabetical character. Number three, the user may enter a character which may not be an alphabetical character. So we will check for all these three conditions and we will display the appropriate message. So as I said before, we will be using the switch statement here. So it's gonna be switch, and in the switch statement's expression part, we will have the ch variable. And then I'm gonna use this curly braces to create the body for this switch statement. Now here, the thing is, this switch statement's expression value must evaluate to an integer value. And here, if you're using the variables, then you can use the variables of type integer, and also you can use the variables of type characters. Here you can use the variables of type characters. That's because when we use the characters in the programming, the ASCII values of those characters are used. And that's why we can specify the character variables here in the switch statement's expression part. All right, now here inside the switch statement's body, we are going to write the cases. The first case will be for the uppercase alphabetical characters. So here, instead of specifying a constant value in the case value part, I will be specifying a range of values. Now, I have already made a tutorial explaining how you can use the range of values in the switch statement's case values. If you haven't watched that tutorial, then I highly recommend you guys to watch that. And here, to specify a range of values, in the switch statement's case value part, first we need to write the keyword case, and then we need to leave a space, and then we need to specify the lower limit of the range. And here we will be writing this case for the characters from capital A to capital Z. So all the values from capital A to capital Z will be the uppercase alphabetical characters. So we can specify that here like this, capital A in single quotes. That's because we write the characters in single quotes. And after that, I need to leave a space, and then I need to add three dots, and then again a space, and then I need to specify the upper limit of this range. So this range is from capital A to capital Z. So I will specify that upper limit here. And after that, I can add a colon. Now here, as I said before, when we use the characters in programming, the ASCII values of these characters are used. And this range is like the range of values from 65 to 90. That's because the ASCII value for the alphabetical character capital A is 65 in decimal, and the ASCII value for the alphabetical character capital Z is 90 in decimal. These values are in the ascending order, that is, the capital A's ASCII value in decimal is 65, and then capital B's ASCII value in decimal is 66, capital C's ASCII value in decimal is 67, and like that. And similarly, the capital Z's ASCII value in decimal is actually 90. So these values are in the ascending order, so we can specify the range here. Now, if the user has entered a character which falls in this range, then that means that the user has entered the uppercase alphabetical character. So we will display a message saying that. So I will use a printf function, and here I will say percentage C is in uppercase, and then I need to specify the CH variable here. For example, if the user is going to enter, let's say, a character capital M, then we are displaying like capital M is in uppercase. So here for this placeholder percentage C, we are specifying the CH variable here. Now, after this statement, we don't want to execute any other statement, so we will be adding this break statement, so that after executing this statement, the control can come out of this switch statement and execute rest of the other statements. So now we have written a case for the uppercase alphabetical characters. Similarly, we need to write the case for the lowercase alphabetical characters. And to do that, I'm going to copy this these three statements, and I'm going to paste it here. And then I'm going to change these values from lowercase A to lowercase Z. Now here, for the character lowercase A, the ASCII value in decimal is 97, and for the character lowercase B, the ASCII value in decimal is 98, and it is in the ascending order for all that lowercase alphabetical characters. So for the character lowercase Z, the ASCII value is 122. So this range is for the ASCII values in decimal from 97 to 122, which is nothing but for the characters lowercase A to lowercase Z. So here we will say percentage C in lowercase, and then we are going to refer the CH variable here. So if the user is going to enter the lowercase alphabetical character, then this will display the message. For example, if the user has entered, let's say, L, then it will say L is in lowercase. So now we have written two cases. One is for the uppercase alphabetical characters, and another one is for the lowercase alphabetical characters. Now, previously I have also talked about what if the user is going to enter a non-alphabetical character. For that also, we want to display a message, and how we can do that here. Now, all of you know that in switch statement, if the switch expression's value doesn't match with any of the case values, then if there is a default case, then that default case's statements will be executed. So here in this program, if the user has entered a non-alphabetical character, then that will not match with this one, and it will not match with this second case also. So here we can have a default case which will be executed if the user is going to enter a non-alphabetical character. So I'll have this default case, and then for this default case I will have a statement displaying a message. So here I'm going to use the printf function, and I'm going to say please enter an alphabet. Okay, so this is the message that we're going to display if the user is going to enter a non-alphabetical character. Now after this, I'm not going to use the break statement. That's because since this is the last part of the switch statement, after executing this statement, there is no other statement to execute inside this switch. So the program will obviously come out of this switch statement and execute the rest of the other statements. So in switch statement, for the last case, you don't need to use the break statement. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna save this program, and I'm gonna build and run this. So let's do build and run, and it says please enter an alphabetical character. Now I'm gonna enter, let's say, capital K, and if I hit the enter button here, it says capital K is in uppercase. And I'm gonna close this program, I'm gonna run it again. This time I'm gonna enter lowercase a, and if I hit the enter button, it says lowercase a is in lowercase, of course. I'm gonna close it, I'm gonna run it one more time, build and run, and this time I'm gonna enter let's say a number 3, and if I hit the enter button, it says please enter an alphabet. So it's working properly. I'm gonna run it one more time, and this time I'm gonna enter a symbol like 8, and if I hit the enter button, it says please enter an alphabet. So it means that this program is working properly. Now here I have used the C programming language to write this program. You can do the same thing in the C++. You can specify a range of values in the switch statement's case value in C++ also. And if you're writing the C++ program here, then you just need to change the printf with the cout, and then you need to change the scanf with the cin. So you'll be able to write the program in the C++ also. Now you can write the program for this problem in many ways, and this is one of the way. So this is it, guys. This is how you guys can write a simple program to ask the user for an alphabetical character, and then you guys can say whether he has entered the uppercase character or the lowercase alphabetical character. Now if you like this video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, then hit the dislike button. If you want to watch more tutorials like this, then do subscribe, and if you want to say something, write that in the comment box. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you later in the next video.